Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Julia Turianski joins us at the bottom of the hour. She's a very popular online liberty-based activist promoting Bitcoin and bringing down the private Federal Reserve. She'll be joining us at the bottom of the hour. Spend a couple segments with us. So look back at Bilderberg that she covered with us as well this year. We have the award-winning filmmaker Joel Gilbert. His new film hits theaters this weekend. There's No Place Like Utopia, exposing what really happens in the economy under socialism and under globalism. And then we have William Binney for a full hour, and he'll take calls the second half of that hour. You can also send your questions, tweet your questions at Real Alex Jones, and we'll ask some of those questions as well. We'll put out an official hashtag or however that works so they can print off the questions for me, and we can throw some of those at William Binney, top NSA whistleblower as well. We'll be joining us and taking your questions in both phone calls and, again, tweet questions in the third hour today. So that's all coming up. Now, I want to just, again, illustrate how disinformation works. And even most politicians don't know this. Like, low-level politicians are just people that believe the system's baloney and parrot it. Mid-level and high-level know how things really work. Our job is to decompartmentalize and show everybody the overall rabbit trick. More Senate Democrats urge Obama to delay immigration order. Top Democrats are pressing President Barack Obama to slow down on immigration reform. You mean totally wide open borders? Further diminishing the chances that he will take sweeping administrative action before Election Day. Senator Bill Nelson, Democrat, Florida, wants Obama to wait until November. Senator Al Franken, what a joke, of Minnesota, said he has concerns about executive action. Well, it's totally illegal. It should be because of that. Senator Angus King, independent of Maine, who caucus with Democrats, said it would be a mistake. They say wait until they've won the Senate election coming up. The Republican leadership wants this as well. They helped write this. This is the North American Union. It's the end of Canadian and Mexican sovereignty. And it's the poorest people coming up here, getting on welfare and further bankrupting things. And I don't dislike them individually. You know, I don't dislike water, as I've said, but if you're submerged under it, you'll drown. Or if it's being fired out of a water hose, the strip mine, you know, can cut you in half. And it's just a giant flood of people who will then just be brainwashed into literal global bots, Obama bots, socialist bots, turning your gun bots. And that's what they're doing. And that's the plan. The Democrats, James O'Keefe got the video in the battleground Texas where they're in person after person going, we're going to bring in all the illegals and vote and take all the guns and get you Texans. They don't care how many of you want to be pro-gun if you're a Texan who's black or Hispanic or white. They're going to bring in people to get a paycheck from the government, and they're going to vote, and they're going to send police and take your guns like New York and California. Done. They did it in California. They're going to do it here. They're going to take your private property. They're going to raise your taxes. They're not going to stop unless we stop them. That's why I get so animated now, is because it's all breaking loose and it's just gotten started. It's just now beginning. Do you understand that? This is not a game. It's not a joke. It's real, 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 real. And people, again, get obsessed about football and their team winning. I'm obsessed with not being totally chumped, totally punked, totally gamed, totally manipulated, and just watching the country destroyed by the globalists like they've done so many others. Like, I hate watching them overthrow Ukraine. I hate watching them overthrow Syria and Iraq. I hate watching them turn Al-Qaeda loose. I just... It's like watching people get mugged and killed and you can't do anything. And then I'm next. You're next. No. No. Good people got to wake up, get together, and take the world back. We'll be right back from break.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
The Genesis Communications Radio Network proudly presents The Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
Everybody knows that I'm a libertarian constitutionalist who listens to this broadcast. When I was critical of Bush and the police state that the Democrats were part of with the Patriot Act, I said it would be targeted on the American people. I said it would be targeted on the libertarian movement. And now they admit Homeland Security under Obama, its main focus is domestic, returning veterans, gun owners, you name it. I've not been an Islamophobe. I don't hate people that are Muslims. I went to college and high school with Muslim folks that were friends, nice people. I was against both Iraq wars. You don't have Saudi Arabia involved in 9/11 and then we attack Iraq. That said, ISIS is a real threat. ISIS has been funded by NATO and Obama in Libya, in Syria, in Iraq. That's all admitted now. They've been given Stinger missiles. That was what Benghazi was about. Colonel Schaefer's on next week. We said that days after it happened. It's now been admitted. Top generals have gone on Fox News and said, no, we gave the missiles to them. But they're a real terror group. Just because the West and criminal elements of our government are working with them doesn't mean they control them. And they are now in Juarez, across from El Paso, inside Homeland Security memos. These were not publicly put out in fake terror alerts for election time. We've got people in the general's office at Fort Bliss. We've got more than that. CIA, you name it. Who people that have been leaked info before, the system doesn't lie, saying there are ISIS groups forming inside Mexico right now, and that's in the news today. ABC News reports, NBC News reports. Texas sheriff says ISIS cells are operating in Juarez, Mexico, and he's ready for them. He was given this in a briefing, online briefing with the feds. Now, whether it's real or not, they're getting us ready for a terror attack that will be used to take our liberties. That's why we sent Joe Biggs down to the border to dress up like a jihadi with an ISIS flag and do a simulated beheading in the park on the Mexico side, inside El Paso, on the edge of town, by the big Mexican flag. Man crosses U.S. border, dresses ISIS terrorist, simulates beheading. Stunt took place in the exact spot where feds say ISIS terror attack is imminent on or before September 11th. Now we also have done the Obama ISIS bucket challenge. That video is up on the site going viral. To try to hijack that meme to point out our borders wide open. This is the collapse of the country, the end of our sovereignty, and they've got domestic police state going on against the Tea Party, the IRS going after veterans groups, libertarian groups, conservative groups, Christian groups, pro-life groups. So we're down there pointing out that they have no security where we need it, and then meanwhile the TSA is literally checking babies' diapers and putting us in naked body scanners to train us how to be prisoners, to train us to be under state control, to end our free society. But I see a minority of the commenters going, Alex, you're with the feds promoting a terror threat. You know, there's no such thing as Islamic extremism, blah, blah, blah. No, there are real Muslim terrorists out there, okay? That's a fact. The government lets them attack, funds them, sometimes totally stages it to be able to take our freedoms. We're pointing the whole thing out preemptively so that if there is an attack, everybody knows they left the border wide open. That's what we're doing. And it's got the trolls hopping mad. I've never supported military action against Serbia or any of these countries. I support Rand Paul saying we got to bomb ISIS right now because they are killing Christians and innocents everywhere. They're taking over. The problem is our government helped set them up to begin with. That's why Obama won't really bomb them. He'll have two or three flights, sorties a day that bomb an old truck or something. Because it's such a PR disaster for them. They're trying to change the name from Al-Qaeda in Iraq to ISIS. Now I'm done. Joel Gilbert joins us. He's got There's No Place Like Utopia. The trailer's up on Infowars.com. And we're going to show some of the trailer while he's talking. And then when he leaves us, we'll also show it. I have no stake in this trailer, in this film. I intend to sell it on DVD when it comes out. He's an excellent filmmaker. He exposed the origins, the true origins of Obama like nobody else. He's an original researcher. Dr. Jerome Corsi and others are in the film. And it needs to get sold out in the cities it opens in so that other theaters will then pick it up so that we can expose what collectivism does. That's why I have activists and filmmakers on and don't just promote ourselves. I didn't sell or plug one thing last hour, even though that's how we fund ourselves. Infowarsstore.com. PrisonPlanet.tv memberships. But I'm having somebody on. I'm not saying I'm some great guy. We do this because we're all in this together. They're scared of these films. They arrested Dinesh D'Souza because they were scared of his films. They've indicted and arrested Rick Perry because they're scared of him. Not that he's perfect, but at least he's trying to secure the border. I've been a big critic of Perry. The point is they're coming after everybody, folks, because we do have a shot. There is a purge going on. There is an attempt to end talk radio's freedom. There is an attempt to come in with internet censorship. Now let's go to Joel Gilbert joining us, the filmmaker with There's No Place Like Utopia. Joel, so much is going on right now. Tell us about where the film's opening, what's going on with that, but then your take on our government openly funding ISIS, the craziness that's going on. I mean, it's just getting so bizarre right now.
Well, unfortunately, it's all quite predictable. I'll tell you first, There's No Place Like Utopia. We opened in Denver a month ago, sold out everything. Now we're in three theaters in the Houston area. Anybody can please come out this weekend on Fandango. You can get tickets in advance. What we're seeing playing out is the socialist Marxist ideology that has permeated and taken over the Democrat Party over the past 20, 30 years. And this is covered and There's No Place Like Utopia. And most people don't realize that the Democrat Party, even well-meaning liberals, don't accept or understand it's been taken over by these radicals. And today it is a radical socialist party. Now, the Marxists and Islamists have been natural allies for the past 60, 70 years.
Absolutely. I have Democrats and ISIS people constantly threatening us now, saying, how dare you not love ISIS? I mean, this is crazy.
Well, let me tell you what they have in common. Both of them are universalist movements. Both Islam and Marxism believe that one day the entire world will be